And France is known for his discovery, along with Jim Watson, of the structure of DNA. And he would occasionally indulge in a double bacon cheeseburger from Jack in the Box. And this ultimate cheeseburger contains more than 1,000 calories, 62% by fat alone. And since the requirement for an average person is only 2,000, this would be more than half your daily requirement, not counting the French fries and the Coke that he actually had on his table with him. And that would take you out for the day, that's for sure. Now, food's a mixture of protein, carbohydrate, and fat. And we need the energy from these things to live on a daily basis, but we may not need all of it. And I'm going to take you on a journey as we take a bite of food and watch as it goes through our bodies from the outside to the inside and what happens to it. And it goes through a series of scripted events. Here is the bite of food that through chewing is broken up, and then through biochemical events begins to be further processed in our bodies. Here it is in our stomach, where it's beginning to break up into its components. The little yellow droplets there are the lipids that we're going to track in more detail. And you'll see that these begin to break up into smaller components through biochemical action. And these will drift from our stomach into the intestine, where absorption of nutrients occurs. And here are the microvilli in the intestine that take the fat from the outside, repackage it on the inside into something called chylomicrons, which travel through the lymphatics, ultimately to the bloodstream, where this fat, this packaged fat, now is delivered to tissues such as the muscle, where it can be used to burn energy, as is shown here, or the excess that is not burned, remember the fat equation, the excess can be will be delivered and stored in adipose tissue. This shows some cells there and our chylomicron droplet delivering the excess energy where it's going to be stored in fat.